September. She burns through the night like an ember. And all those things we try forgetting, I remember. But we say we all fine, we all fine. Sunny day dreams and we up now. Vodka lemonade, I serve it up, it goes down. 75 degrees in a dope sound. All you need to live fine, to live fine.
Well, I call it FranCeils, even though there's no and. It's either a dash, and in the old days, sometimes a slash, or just FranCeils. But I call it FranCeils.
Cause I figured out, the more I slow down, the less I get out. And if we fall, let's be strong now.
The original owner, you know, he built it in 1954. My dad bought it in 1980. I started working here after I graduated from St. Francis because I didn't know what I wanted to do. I went to college for a year or two. Wasn't really sure, and my dad said, well, while you're figuring it out, why don't you run FranCeils? That was when I was 21. I'm gonna be 50 next week. I've been here that long because I really like it. I like winters off. I'll just say.
Alright, loose cannon, but still it won't fight. No need to leave, spend our whole lives.
Well, I suppose it could make me stand out different from, say, a Dairy Queen or places like that that have to use what the national franchise wants them to use. But there's a lot of things I could try that are just don't necessarily work. It's a pretty proven formula, Dairy Queen being our baseline, like what works for them. You know, you got your hot fudge and your strawberry sun, your banana split. So I kind of copy them, but don't get me wrong, I didn't create all this. I'm just carrying on the tradition. But I have tried different things in the past to maybe stand out, and nothing new really seems to work. It's, you know, people want their hot fudge sundae or their small twist. I mean, that's, you go with what works. My father once said, you know, keep it simple, stupid. You know, don't try and overthink it. Don't try and have too many different varieties. But being an independent business, I do have the freedom to try things. I can try stuff once in a while and see if it works. And I like to have that freedom, but I wouldn't say it makes me any more successful.
All the good comes in waves. I buy my time by the ocean. And at night, I'm awake to feel the weight of your motion. And I want something that's feeling alright. Blues can it.
Working with Joe in a smaller business, there's more like, I feel like I can talk to him more about things. It's not so like, there's more like communication. It's not like I have to go like on like above him or like above like his boss, like a general manager or something. It's more like, there's more communication, like when there's like problems and things, like I know that I can like talk to him about like really anything, and it's more like hands-on, like him being here instead of like being a franchise where he's like always gone. Like he's always here, he's always helping us, like for anything we need, he's always able to be here.
These games we play, they got us really far. That shit to most won't ever mean a thing, but it got us here, so I hold all the good comes in waves.
That's a good question. I don't know if I have an answer for how it would make me be more efficient. Just knowing what my cost is without having to deal with the franchise fees and all that stuff, it's easier to project budgets. Like I know what I want to spend for advertising because I know what my costs are totally. Like where if you're in a franchise on McDonald's or a Dairy Queen, they tell you what to do and you have no control over that. So I guess because I can control stuff like advertising budgets, it helps me be more efficient.
That's our biggest thing. It's like the biggest thing I tell everyone when I hire them and like when I'm interviewing them is I tell them that like if you don't have good customer service, obviously you can't work here. We have people that have been coming here for literally 60 years. So making them happy and making them come back, and then they bring their grandkids, and then their grandkids bring their kids, and then their parents bring all their kids. So having repeat customers and having that like base of everyone bringing their families, it really makes for like it makes our name like really. So it's literally families from when they open bringing their families and telling their friends, and then they bring all their friends, and like it's basically just like it's word of mouth with a small business like this. So if you upset one person, they're gonna tell one person, and it's gonna like. It's gonna spread like wildfire. And people don't think that, like, if one thing happens with one customer, it's not a big deal. And like, oh, it's only one customer. Well, one customer can bring their grandkids and their kids and their kids bring their kids. And it could be 25 people that end up don't coming back, and that does affect us because we are only one location. So customer service is the biggest thing obviously we have to focus on. So we try to make the customer happy, and the customer's always right. So customer service is our number one thing.
Took pills with the name I'd never heard, but they were for sleep, she fooled me. That's when I noticed that something was strange, out of my range, there was no way back.
Well, you know, the good thing about this place, I don't have to do any of this. This place, if you're from the South Towns, you're from the area, it almost has a cult following, which is, like I said, I'm the third owner, so it's not for me, but I'm not changing anything because I want to keep that cult following, that status, you know, going. So I do a little bit of advertising in local newspapers and stuff, but word of mouth for this place is really strong. I can't tell you how many times I have a customer come up on a daily basis and say, I grew up in Lackawanna or Blaisdell or Orchard Park, and I moved out of town, and I come back, and every time we come back, we got to go to FranCeils, and all my friends are posting cones on Facebook that still live here. You know, so it's almost got legs of its own. I don't really have to do much because of that. I'm really lucky in that way.
I noticed that something was strange, out of my range, there was no way back.
You know, so that's the thing. It's really a built-in following that I don't have to do much for. I'm really lucky that way. So I'm just trying to keep it going and make slight improvements here and there, but I don't want to change too much.
Not tell everyone, and the look on your face.
But I really got lucky because it was an established business, and I could have changed the name as soon as I bought it. I could have called it Joe's Custard. But then people go, oh, it's different, it's a different owner. Why change something that works?
You won't know me when the feeling's all gone.
Yes, I think it's more beneficial for me. Now, if you're having a franchise, you have a franchise behind you and advertising and stuff like that. So that's, I don't have TV commercials or anything like that or a national brand, but the sole owner and my own boss is I think it's way more beneficial in my situation.